Umar Shariff.
First of all, I must congratulate the doctor because I am totally in line with his thoughts. Mm. Because whatever comes in the world, it has to be checked. And then we need to find proofs and evidences. Yes. Mm. And today there's so many things. And in fact, when I went through the article, it said, it is believed. And it is said, it could. So all these words, you know, it's very beautifully used. Mm-hmm. But you know, a person like you, even you as an anchor, sometimes you make a mistake. You're like, yeah, you can live. Mm. But the article doesn't say that. The article says you could live. And again, it says it is believed. Mm-hmm. So it is faith. So faith, there are so many other faiths also. You know, if somebody is saying...
No, but he's saying that I've tried it on my father, on my aunt, on myself and whatnot.
This is anecdotal evidence.
Yes.
It is not a scientific evidence.
It is anecdotal evidence.
Exactly. Few random people on which he's tried.
He's tried.
It's worked on a few random.
He is trying.
So now we need to...
He's
we
trying.
Need to conduct clinical trials, one
after the other.
The way you see it is what we call as anecdotal evidence. He says that he tried this pill and they're living longer. Mm. But the confounding factors could be many. They should be doing regular exercises. They may be eating something, you know, very regular diet. Mm. So those factors may have had much more influence than the pill that they've been taking.
Okay.
So there is no way I can say that it is only
because of the pill.
That's what happened.
Going back to Omar. Yeah.
So coming to the point. As Albert Einstein once said, science without religion is lame, and religion without science is blind. Mm. So both have to, you know, be
hand in hand,
and that's so people can explore the beauty of the unseen. Mm. So that's how I look into it. I think most of the religious people, or even the people of the scientific background, they also would agree to some point. You know, there's always a debate between the evolutionist theory and the creationist theory. That is there. Let us have that debate also, the healthy debate.
Right.
Now, having said that, how do we see aging? You know, how do we see aging? As far as the Quran is concerned, I need to speak a little bit of religious angle to this.
Yes.
Quran says a man is born as a baby, and then he develops to become an adult, and he is given strength. At some point, he is also made weak, and he is made old. And there is a sign for a people who ponder in this, that you cannot be here as a resident forever on this earth. So get prepared to the life after death. But when you think that this pill is going to make me feel comfortable for the next 150 years, then you feel like, yeah, I'm going to be safe. I mean, I don't have to be bothered about life after death.
I mean, the pill does not make you immortal.
It can't make.
You have
to
die.
But a kind of, you know, a person is given a kind of a placebo, kind of, even
if
through
you
this.
You can get a better quality.
If a person, it's a placebo.
Yeah, better quality life.
Better quality.
That's true.
Better quality.
I mean, whatever it is, at least, even if you're living up to 150, at least by 148, you'll be worried, oh, in 2 years,
let me
tell
you. Let me tell you, there's a person living now for more than 2,000 years.
Yes.
What?
Father would be able to tell me, Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him.
Yeah.
According to me, the Quran says, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ. The Quran says, nobody killed him, nobody crucified him, but he is alive. What do you say about that?
That's getting too spiritual.
Can we all have the pill that Jesus had? Jesus doesn't need
more,
the pill.
One more,
he is alive.
What does Jesus need? And we want what Jesus has.
One more.
I thought Jesus has given away everything that he has. He's not given us the secret to long life.
Just for a second.
He has.
Just for a second. As he has rightly pointed out about the Jesus,
right,
our philosophy, our people, our ancestors, they are telling that there are Chiranjeevis. They are still alive. Seven people are there in our world, like Anjaneya. So many people are there. You know,
I mean, you know what? Let's talk about what we can see. What is visibly present in front of us?
Okay. Another angle for you to understand.
Yeah.
See, 150 is a big number now. Because I am a spiritual person and you wanted the angle from here.
Of course, yeah.
Prophet said the people in the earlier years, they used to live for long duration. Like, for instance, even if you see the Bible, you'll come to know Noah lived for 950 years, according to the Quran. Mm. And again, Adam, the first man, he lived for 1,000 years. Mm. And even if you see the bodies of the ancient old, their skeleton is almost 10 times of ours, the size-wise. So it was done in that way. Mm. For the people of that time. But now the Prophet said, for the Ummah, for the people of my times, the average is 60 years. Mm. So we don't have much hopes. Prophet went to the extent to say, when I pray, I don't know, I'll be praying the next prayer. Mm. In the sense, you pray as though this is your last prayer.
Last day, yeah.
So If you are going to have this kind of attitude, you will feel a sense of accountability.
Okay, I got it. So you're basically trying to say, even if this pill came into existence, it's not good for us.
No, I wouldn't say that. No, if it is experimented and proven, I wouldn't mind having it. Seriously. Right, okay. And it has to be proven.
Okay.
See, there's no harm.
It has to be proven. Get your concern. Totally get your concern.
For the most vulnerable
it
person.
It should be understood the right sense. Yeah. In the sense, a lot of people, you know, after delivering the child, they would say like they wouldn't want to give breastfeed, you know. So for that, it is scientifically proven.
It's not for fashion sake, but I think it hurts
proven that
for the mothers. That's what I've heard.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's true.
From that perspective.
I was just coming to you, Omar. I mean, Mr. Udaya spoke about Ayurveda and Ayush, whatnot. Can you shed some light on Unani? Is there something that has, properties
see,
to
basically,
long life?
It's a misnomer, misunderstanding or misrepresentation. Ayurveda belongs to us as much as it belongs to Dr. Udaya.
The point here is...
I'm just saying that
Unani doesn't have anything to do with religion. Has got nothing to do with religion. That's what I'm trying
true.
To say.
That's true.
Ayurveda, Charaka, Shushruta, and all these great people who are practicing medicine in those years, those times, they have left a great legacy. Mm-hmm. If they were not there today, whatever we are doing, it wouldn't have been a possibility.
Exactly.
Similarly, when we talk about Unani is again Greek medicine.
Yes.
You know, it is Greek and Roman, from there, some people have adopted.
Right.
But today, mostly a lot of people amongst the Muslim sections, they practice Unani. And they also practice cupping.
Mm-hmm.
You might be knowing cupping. And they call it as hijama.
Yes.
But hijama originated in China, but it was adopted later on.
Mm.
So what I have to say, see, religion is a personal thing.
Mm.
But again, if you want to relate every religious community, at some point you'll find a common thread.
Yes.
And I'm sure you would. If you go into a research, you will find.
Because we're all humans.
Yeah.
And
our bodies, our biology is the same.
Yes. And I want to say a very important thing. The Prophet said, Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafiya wa rizqan tayyiba wa amalan muntakabbala. Meaning of it is, O God Almighty, give me the beneficial knowledge. He didn't say, give me the knowledge from the Arab society. He said, beneficial knowledge. If something is coming from Harvard University or something is coming from the times of Charaka and Shushruta, wherever it is coming from, let us adopt the best practices.
Mm-hmm.
And wa rizqan tayyiba, let my striving for life be a lawful one.
Mm-hmm.
Let me not do anything, malpractice or adulterated, like anything. If you want to sell in the market, in the name of, health and fitness,
where
a lot of things is being marketed, most likely, as most of them really agreed upon, this could also be a market gimmick.
Yes, absolutely. Omar Shariff, how do you convince yourself if these kind of pills really bring some sort of hope that, my life can come back.
With regards
I can have the most happening, exciting life once again.
Yeah, yeah.
It is depressing and it's very difficult to tell yourself. As much as we say it's all right, it's okay, you go back home and start sulking again. So how do you really keep that mental frame of mind?
See, the thing is, let us do something which is possible. I don't dream of something which is, not true or doubtful or conjecture, which is not certain. I would do something which is practical. I go to the gym. I personally go to the gym. I make sure that I eat mostly the organic food.
Mm.
I stay away from all the preservatives and all that, which is going to be carcinogenic.
Mm.
So I do which is researched and established.
Mm.
Let us all do whatever is fact. Mm. Why do we have to go about something which is not sure? One thing. And to be beautiful or handsome is something which I desire.
Mm.
And I think all the religious people should desire.
Mm.
Doesn't mean that, when you have gray hair, you don't look beautiful or handsome. See, beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. How is that? How you carry yourself? George Clooney, you look at him with the gray hair, looks awesome. Look at Jim Carrey, he looks awesome. And even for that matter, Gandhi ji, with all that, whatever he had, his own persona, he was looking awesome.
Beauty.
Nobody can debate on that, I feel. With that two dhoti and one Gandhi ji.
Did he have a lot of girlfriends?
Of course. If you get into my experiment with the truth, if you go into the book, my experiment with the truth, you'll find a lot of things which he has explained. But I don't want to talk in this.
Okay, no, I get it. Beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder.
That's
but true. Like I said, a lot of them don't accept it. Aesthetics matter.
That's
Father First Day. All right. Thank you so much.
Don't forget to drink milk.
Yes.
Don't forget to drink milk. Absolutely. I think that should be our sign-off note.
Yes,
thank you so much
yes.
for joining us and shedding that light.